Okay, a very good morning, dear students. Welcome to my channel, Maths with Mahanti Sir. Today, children, let us complete the chapter circle. Children, in the last class, we were discussing one important property of cyclic quadrilateral, where I discussed that an isosceles trapezium is always cyclic. How to prove geometrically that an isosceles trapezium is always cyclic? It was discussed in detail by me, and I am sure you must have understood. Prior to that, we have already discussed so many properties of cyclic quadrilateral. The geometrical truths relating to properties of cyclic quadrilateral have already been discussed in earlier classes. And today, let us complete the chapter by discussing the last property of cyclic quadrilateral. So, what is the last property? It is a very important one, and it is also a very bit complicated one. Let us discuss what is the property. See, sum of the sum of angles in the four segments. You see, what is the meaning? I will explain it. Sum of angles in the four segments exterior to a cyclic quadrilateral. What is the meaning? See, this is such a complicated figure. You see, first you take a cyclic quadrilateral. Suppose A, B, C, D is a cyclic. I am first explaining the statement, then I will discuss the proof. See, suppose A, B, C, D is a cyclic quadrilateral, it is given. Now, exterior to this cyclic quadrilateral, see this, you know what is a segment. Already we have discussed. Segment means the region or space between chord and arc. See, now AB is a chord and this is the arc. So, this is one segment. Now, in this segment, APB, look at, here the four segments are, you see, I have divided the whole circle into four segments. See, APB is one segment, this one, this arc APB, this can be one segment. I am just showing it by means of dotted lines. You see, this is one segment. Similarly, BQC, this region between, you see, the region within the chord BC and this arc. BQC is an arc, BC is a chord. So the space between this chord and the arc is another segment. So there are four segments, segment 1, segment 2, segment 3 and segment 4. Okay, the cyclic quadrilateral has been divided into four segments. Okay, now if it has been divided into four segments, look at the angles. Look at the angles. You see, I am drawing once again. Look at this angle, angle P. Look at angle P. Look at angle Q. Look at angle R. And look at angle S. This is angle S. You see, angle P, angle Q, angle R, and angle S. These are four angles. Where they have been formed? They have been formed in the exterior of this cyclic quadrilateral ABCD. Okay. So what is the statement? What is the property? The property says that in a cyclic quadrilateral, the four angles, that is angle P, angle Q, angle R, and angle S, these four angles which are formed exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral, their sum will be equal to 6 right angles. You see, 6 right angles means 6 into 90 degrees. That means if ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral and this is exterior, angle P, angle Q, angle R, and angle S, these are four angles which are exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral ABCD, then the sum of these four angles which are exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral ABCD is equal to 6 right angles, means 540 degrees. So how to prove that angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S is equal to 540 degrees? See, it is a very interesting property. Let us prove it. Children, I hope you understood what is the statement of this particular property of cyclic quadrilateral. That means in a cyclic quadrilateral, the four angles, if ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, you prove that the four sum of the four angles, this angle, this angle, this angle, and this angle, sum of the four angles which are exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral. Exterior means they are formed in the, exterior means what? These angles will be formed in the four segments. I told you what, this is one segment, there are four segments. I have divided the whole cyclic quadrilateral into four segments. You see, there are four segments. In the four segments which are exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral, how many angles are there? Four. So you prove that the sum of these four angles is how many degrees? 6 right angles, that is 540 degrees. Now the point is how to prove it. Okay, let us see. So what is given? So children, I hope you must have understood the statement. statement of this property. Now let us write given. What is given? So given is ABCD is a what? It is a cyclic quadrilateral. And look at angle P. Angle P, angle Q, angle R and angle S. These four angles are exterior to. These are exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral ABCD. These are exterior angles. Exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral ABCD. Now what we want to prove? We have to prove that their sum. The sum of these four angles. The sum of these four angles P, Q, R and S. Which are exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral. Their sum is to prove angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S. Okay. Equal to how many degree? It is equal to 6 into 90 degree. 6 right angles. Means 540 degree. Let us see how. Now to prove it, we need some construction. So what is the construction? The construction is, you join this and S. PQRS, yes. Join SB and SC. That is the construction. Join SB and SC. Okay. Now let us see how to prove. Let us come to the proof part. How can we prove that the sum of these four angles P, Q, R and S which lie to the which are exterior to the cyclic quadrilateral ABCD, their sum is 540 degree. How to prove? See children, now this angle S, when we joined SD and SC, look at this angle S can be divided into three parts. Look at this one angle ASB, suppose denoted by 1. Now look at angle BSC, this is another angle, you denote it by 2. Then angle DSC or CSD, whatever you say, denoted by angle 3. Now look at angle S has been divided into 3 parts. Okay, angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3. That means if you add angle 1 plus 2 plus 3, you will get angle S. Okay, now let me discuss the proof. See, if you look at the figure, look at A, P, B and S. A, P, B and S. Look at the four vertices. These four vertices lie on the circle. So, no doubt A, P, B, S is a cyclic quadrilateral. So, we can say that A, P, B, S is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay. As the four vertices lie on the circle, as all its four vertices lie on the circle, so no doubt AP, see this is P, APBS will be a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay. Now if APBS is a cyclic quadrilateral, look at angle 1 and angle P. So these two are opposite angles. If APBS is a cyclic quadrilateral, then angle 1 and angle P, they are one pair of opposite angles and we know that they will be supplementary. Each pair of opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is supplementary. So therefore, 1 plus P, angle 1 plus angle P must be equal to 180 degrees. So, you write down. Therefore, angle 1 plus P equal to 180 degrees. The reason is very simple, because opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, now you see. Now see. B, Q, A, B, B, S. A, B, B, S over. Then B, Q, C, S. Look at the four vertices B, Q, C and S. Again, the vertices B, Q, C and S, they also lie on the same circle or one circle. So no doubt, B, Q, C, S will be another what? Cyclic quadrilateral. So, similarly, BQCS is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay. Now see, if BQCS is a cyclic quadrilateral, look at angle 2 and angle Q. Look at angle 2 and angle Q. BQCS. You see? BQCS. Yes. If BQCS is a cyclic quadrilateral, so clearly angle 2 and angle Q, they are opposite angles. And they must be supplementary or their sum will be 180 degree. So we can write angle 2 plus angle Q equal to again 180 80 degree. Okay. So first we took APBS cyclic quadrilateral. We got angle 1 plus 3, 180 degree. Then we took the cyclic quadrilateral BQCS and we got angle 2 plus Q equal to 180 degree. Now look at CRBS. C. Look at the vertices C, R, B and S. Do they lie on the same circle? The answer is yes. So as the four vertices C, R, B and S lie on the same circle, so no doubt C, R, B, S is also a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay? We can say that C, R, B, S is a cyclic quadrilateral because the four vertices C, R, B and S, they lie on the same circle. So now what will happen? Let us see. So if C, R, B, S is a your cyclic quadrilateral, then what will happen? Look at C, R, B and S. Look at angle 3. Look at angle 3 and look at angle R. Look at angle 3 and look at angle R. So clearly angle 3 and R, what angles are they? They are opposite angles. They are opposite angles of the cyclic quadrilateral C, R, D, S. So our C, R, D, S is a cyclic quadrilateral and angle 3 and angle R are opposite angles. So their sum will be also 180 degree because they are supplementary. So our conclusion will be what? Angle 3 plus angle R equal to 180 degree. Now you just make it equation. Suppose this is the first equation. Angle 2 plus Q, let it be equation 2. And angle 3 plus R, let it be equation 3. Okay? Now we got three equations. Now the next step, you add all the three equations. And children, you know how to add equations. When we add equations, we add their left hand side and we also add their right hand side. Okay. So adding, I am writing here, adding equation 1, 2 and 3. Adding 1, 2 and 3. Let us see what is obtained. What will be obtained if we add angle 1, 2 and 3? See, this is the left hand side. So you add angle 1 plus angle P. Then angle 2, look at, plus angle Q. Then here angle 3 plus angle R. So angle 3 plus angle R, yes. So now I added the left hand side of all the three equations. Then I have to add the right hand side of the three equations also. See, here it is 180, 180 and 180. So this is 180 plus 180 plus 180 degree, okay. Now let us rearrange. You see. Now you rearrange all these. You see. Already angle P plus Q. Angle P plus Q plus R. There. So write out angle P plus angle Q plus angle R. Now you group angle 1, angle 2 and angle 3. Rearrange them in one group. That means plus angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3. And this will be equal to how many degrees? 500. 40, 180 plus 180 plus 180, it is 180 into 3, that is 540 degree. Now look at angle 1 plus 2 plus 3, what will it give? Look at the figure. Angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3, it will give you which angle? It will certainly give you angle S. Because 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to angle S. So in place of angle 1 plus 2 plus 3, you can write angle S. So write down. So angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle what? S. Equal to 540 degree. That means what did we prove? So this is what we wanted to prove. So therefore we proved that angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S is equal to how many degree? 540. 540 means it is 6 into 90 degree. 6 into 90 degree or 6 right angles. You see. 6 right angles. Okay. So this is what we wanted to prove. Thus, what did we see, children? So we proved the truth that in a cyclic quadrilateral, in any cyclic quadrilateral, the four angles which are formed to the exterior. Exterior means in four segments. Exterior means in four segments of the circle, you see. So the four angles which are formed to the exterior of a cyclic quadrilateral, their sum will always be equal to 6 right angles or 540 degrees. 6 right angles or 540 degrees. Okay, children, I hope you must have understood the proof of this truth, this property of cyclic quadrilateral. So, with this, we completed all the properties. I have discussed everything about cyclic quadrilateral
there is nothing that I have left. I have discussed almost all the properties of cyclic quadrilateral, which are very, very important from the examination point of view. Because you will definitely get one question from cyclic quadrilateral in the annual exam of class 9. And even in class, in the midterm or half yearly examination. If at all, circles will be there in the syllabus. You will definitely get a question on cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, children. So, with this, we came to the end of the chapter, that is circle. Everything is complete. We shall discuss another chapter, new chapter in the next class. Perhaps statistics or probability, we will see. We will discuss either statistics or probability in the next class. With this, we completed the chapter, that is your circle. And I am sure my dear students must have understood. And if at all it is true, if you think yes, the way Mahanti sir explains us the thing, he explains us in a very simple language, he makes everything simple and we are able to understand what he is explaining, then children, I must say that you please hit the like button and subscribe my channel, okay? So we will again meet in the next class with the discussion of some new chapter, okay? Thank you.